Buongiorno a tutti, benvenuti a Doppio Espresso, l'italiano in corso. Oggi, in questo episodio, affrontiamo il come, usato per chiedere come ti chiami e usato anche per chiedere come stai. Sono gli usi più comuni di questo avverbio. Hello everybody, welcome to Doppio Espresso, l'italiano in corso. Today we are approaching come, question word for how are you, come stai, but also question word what is your name, come ti chiami. And we will see a verb, present tense, il verbo chiamarsi, verb chiamarsi, which means when you use it, you use the verbo chiamarsi to present yourself, to tell which is your name. It will be sort of call in literally translation in English, but actually it is used in Italian to say one's name. So just begin with the presentation, grammar presentation of adverb come. Quindi incominciamo con gli avverbi interrogativi. So let's start with gli avverbi interrogativi. Question words come, used in the sense of what is your name, or how, come ti senti. Come ti chiami? Come, what's your name? Come ti chiami? What's your name? Mi chiamo Elena. My name is Elena. Come vi chiamate? Siamo Elena e Andrea, i vostri vicini. What are your names? We are Elena e Andrea, your neighbors. Come si chiama quel ragazzo? What's that boy's name? Si chiama Francesco. He is Francesco. Come si chiamano quelle persone? What's those people's name? Si chiamano Luca e Paolo. They are Luca and Paolo. So, if you see, il verbo chiamarsi, verb chiamarsi, doesn't exactly exist in a perfect translation in English. It is used literally chiamare. The verb chiamare exists and means call for someone. Chiamarsi is to tell one's name, okay? And as we have seen in the previous episode, please don't forget that in Italia you do not need to put always the subject in front of the verb. So just go on the explanation. And we will see il verbo chiamarsi detailed in the different person, because surprise, surprise, Italian grammar is so tricky, and in English grammar you have just the first, the third person with S, the present tense, and then the other person are all the same, not in Italian. And Italian is a Latin language, as French and Spanish, so it's a bit more tricky. Spanish people or French people who are looking will be easier for them, because they are accustomed to these tricky things. So just read through the verb chiamarsi. Io mi chiamo, tu ti chiami, lui, lei si chiama, noi ci chiamiamo, voi vi chiamate, loro si chiamano. So, pay attention. This is just to be clear so that you can have all, you can get all information. We will see these kinds of verbs which are tricky and complicated, but in order to give you all the explanation, I have written these all together. Il verbo chiamarsi. Io mi chiamo, I am, my name is, not literally, but this would be the translation. Tu ti chiami, your name is, lui, lei, he, she, si chiama, Her name, his name is. Noi ci chiamiamo. Our name is. Voi vi chiamate. Your name is. Loro si chiamano. Their name is. So, hop. Io mi chiamo, tu ti chiami, lui, lei si chiama, noi ci chiamiamo, voi vi chiamate, loro si chiamano. Yeah, also a reflexive verb. That means that I call myself, you call yourself. It doesn't exist in English, but in order to explain you, so it's very tricky, but very common verb and expression when you are introducing yourself or speaking yourself, present someone or something. Okay. So, practice make perfect. La pratica rende perfette, perfetti, niente panico, no panic, and go further. Come stai? This is another use of the verb come, of the adverb come. Questo è un altro uso del verb, dell'avverbio come. Come stai? How are you? Allora, adesso leggo e voi provate a seguirmi. Come stai? Bene, grazie. E tu? How are you? Fine, thank you. And yourself? Questo come stai is how are you doing? And the answer, bene, it's okay, fine, is good. Bene, come state? Molto bene, grazie. Voi? How are you? We are doing very well, thanks. And yourself? Quindi molto bene is very well. Bene is okay. Molto bene is ok, very ok. Come sta Lucia? How is Lucia? Sta così e così, she is so-so, così così, insomma. Come sta il tuo cane? How is your dog? Sta male. He is bad, male, not good bad. Come stanno Andrea e Elena? How are Andrea and Elena? Stanno abbastanza bene. They are not so bad. Abbastanza is it's okay, is 60% abbastanza. It's not 80%, it's not 40%, it's not 50%, it's 60-65%. Abbastanza bene. Okay, this is all the graduation. This is the graduation, so if you can say put it in this way. Of the way someone feels, is feeling. Ok, come stai? Bene, grazie. Tu? Come state? Molto bene, grazie. E voi? Come sta Lucia? Sta così così. Come sta il tuo cane? Sta male. Come stanno Andrea e Elena? Stanno abbastanza bene. You notice this little, grazie, e tu? Prego, this is this little Italian word, thanks, so it's just to make always the sentence more polite and sympathetic with the person we are talking to. Okay, Latin people. So, il verbo stare. It is a graduation, if you want, of a verb to be. Stare, essere. But also diventare, become, are all the graduation of the big verb to be. Il verbo stare is referred, in this case, to the state of mind and state physical, of the physical state. Verbo stare means also to stay in the sense of a physical position, a stay in this country, for example, a stay in this position. But in this case it is used in order to express how you are feeling. Il verbo stare si riferisce in questo caso allo stare fisico o mentale o anche emotivo della persona, ma in generale il verbo stare indica anche fisicamente la posizione della persona. Sto seduto oppure sto in piedi. Quindi il verbo stare. Io sto, tu stai, lui, lei sta, noi stiamo, voi state, loro stanno. Quindi, in this case the translation should be I stay, but you know, you are referring to a state of a feeling. So, io sto, I am, or I stay, tu stai, lui, lei sta, noi stiamo, voi state, loro stanno. I prefer not to translate because it's not really, it would be not so exact translation in English, so take it as it is. Il verbo stare più il modo di stare. Sto bene, male, abbastanza bene, così e così, eccetera, eccetera, eccetera. Ok, go further.
And so, now as promised in the previous episode, you'll find here the written solution to the exercises. Ora, come anticipato, promesso nell'episodio precedente, vi presento le soluzioni scritte agli esercizi proposti nell'episodio precedente. Seguite con me. And now I am going to read the new words. Ora leggiamo le parole nuove, new words, for this episode. So I read the Italian version and then the Italian version and the translation. So I will read twice. So now let's start with the Italian version. Abbastanza. Attenzione, grazie, la panna, la mamma, fresco, un caffè, un cappuccino, la pizza, gli spaghetti, la pasta, la panna, il cornetto, a colazione. So now we read Italian and English so that you can have the translation together. Adesso leggo l'italiano e l'inglese così che abbiate la versione in italiano e la traduzione. Abbastanza, enough. Attenzione, attention. Grazie, thanks. La panna, cream. La mamma, mom. Fresco, ready made, un caffè e coffee, un cappuccino, cappuccino I didn't translate because it's cappuccino is milk and coffee together, typical Italian coffee version, la pizza, also word well known, gli spaghetti, you know, pasta, spaghetti, it's typical of Italian plate, la pasta, it's another way to say spaghetti, it's sort of noodle, but it's typical Italian noodle, so la pasta. La panna, the cream. Il cornetto, the croissant. A colazione, at breakfast. Please take note that as in next, in previous episodes, I have also written the article in front of the word. Why did I do this? Because I think it's important to start learning and listening to the article, whether it's feminine or masculine. In the next episodes, be patient, in one of next episodes, I think in two or three, now I have not a definite idea, you will have a specially dedicated episode to the use of article, determinative article and indeterminative article, translated in Italian. Come vedete, vi do l'elenco delle parole con l'articolo davanti. Perché? Perché penso sia importante incominciare a sentire, ad ascoltare l'articolo, sia femminile che maschile, così che possiate abituarvi a questo uso del maschile e del femminile dell'articolo davanti al nome. Non fatevi problemi, non abbiate problemi perché in uno dei prossimi episodi, non so bene ancora quali, penso tra due o tre episodi, dedicherò una lezione intera all'articolo determinativo e indeterminativo, al suo uso, al suo genere, al singolare e al plurale. So, again, be patient, exercise, don't stop learning and enjoy and learn more Italian. Ciao ciao!